I had just asked Dr. Grimsley about if I'm paranoid because I do what I do when I leave, when I exit the bathroom. Am I paranoid?
I can't answer that question completely because I'm not a psychologist, Bob, but...
Well, you could take a guess, but no, that's all right, yeah.
But it's interesting you raise that point because we have just produced a brochure which is actually in front of you.
And that brochure we're showing on the camera right now.
Oh, great.
Okay.
So. And that does describe the process you just described. That it's recommended that if you have any doubt about the cleanliness of the institution you're in or the room you're in, use paper towels to hold closed faucets and open doors.
Thank you. I feel better. But you know, one of the things I didn't use as an example, that when you get done sitting down and relieving yourself, most of the times you then flush the toilet. I realize that now more and more toilets are automatic flush.
Sure.
But there are still, how many hundreds of people are touching that?
Well, that's absolutely right. And as you know, we secrete millions of organisms. So the simple act of touching that lever transfers hundreds of thousands, millions of organisms, which are then transferred to the next person. And that's why hand hygiene is so important, because otherwise that is taken out of the room and spread everywhere that the person goes.
Hmm. You know, I just wanted to add, though, that the process of what happens, so after you go to the bathroom and you flush the toilet, it is important that that's the next step is that you go and wash your hands. So, you know, there's an element of what you might describe as hypervigilance, you know, that question, am I being overly cautious? Well, we are living in a world of bacteria. And so it's important to understand that, you know, number one, not everybody is sick. And number two, not everybody has something to transfer. And there are, at least for some of the bacteria, it's natural for us to have them in our bodies. And being exposed to certain bacteria and viruses are very important for our immune system. So I think that, you know, when you think about you flush the toilet, the next step is for you, of course, after you get yourself fully dressed, is that you go to the sink and then you wash your hands. So, you know, at every step.
Well, the first thing I do is look in the mirror and, yeah, you know, fix my three hairs that I have on my head and, you know, and say, we're having a good day.
Yeah. Well, maybe that's a good time to wash your hands first.
Okay.
Then fix your hair and have a good day, because I think that would improve, you know, your risk of bacterial exposure or viral exposure. So take the process all the way through. You know, what I don't want to create is this sort of world of I should be living in a bubble or in some sterile environment. It's important to realize that exposure to viruses and bacteria is part of our everyday life. What we don't want is to make ourselves sick. And so doing things like leaving the toilet and washing your hands is very important.
All right, let's imagine that I'm now in the men's room of a major hotel casino. And the men's room is enormous because there's so much traffic. Mm-hmm. In this particular men's room, there is a shoe shine place where you can step up and get your shoes shined, and you watch everybody come and everybody go. And smack in front of you are the sinks. I don't understand, and this is for both of you, and it's the truth. How many guys come in holding a glass or a cup full of beer, they put it on top of the urinal, they go to the bathroom, they come back, they take their cup down, they wash their hands. But more often than not, I can't tell you how many people come in, go to the bathroom, and they leave. They don't wash their hands. Did they miss something in elementary school?
No, I mean, it's obviously important to wash your hands because you don't know if you are infected with something or incubating something that you could pass on to somebody. And as Dr. Green said, you can't overreact to these situations, but you have to be aware that some viruses and some germs are dangerous. And so we really have to encourage everybody to wash their hands at certain times to protect all of us. And some people are much more susceptible than others. For example, the elderly can die of a disease caused by organisms that other people, it doesn't bother them at all. So that's why cleanliness overall is very important in blocking that step between one person infected and one person not infected. But I just emphasize again what Dr. Green said. We shouldn't overreact. We've got to be sensible too, because our immune systems will take care of most things. But it's often the people who've got a minor problem with their immunity or a temporary problem with their immunity that are going to suffer.
I think there's probably a lot of viewers, you know, as we've been talking about that, has said, come on, Fisher, ask the question. And the question is about the hand sanitizers, that you can have the little bottles, the antibacterial hand sanitizers. There are machines now that you go like this. We're finding them more and more in public buildings. We're finding them, certainly people who cruise know they're everywhere on the ship. What's the difference between washing your hands at the sink with soap as opposed to just using the hand sanitizer and then eat your meal?
Well, hand sanitizers are designed for when your hands look generally clean.
Say that again, because that's really important, isn't it?
Yeah, if your hands are clean, you can use a hand sanitizer. But of course, you're not wiping away the bugs. You're just killing the bugs.
And they
remain on your skin, but that's okay. They're dead.
To have dead bugs on your skin?
Yeah, but you've got bugs on your skin all the time.
I don't.
Your whole body is covered with them. No, I don't see any, but I assure you there are plenty there. It will kill the bugs, and it has some residual effect, and it'll keep killing the bugs.
But if I wash my hands,
and
I'm holding it under the faucet, wouldn't that get rid of the bugs?
Well, that's the benefit of hand washing.
So you do.
Because if your hands are covered in dirt, it washes the dirt away, which often contain the bugs, or the bugs will hide in the dirt. And also it'll wash the bugs off your hands even if they're clean. So that's the major benefit of hand washing. It doesn't actually kill them. It washes them away to a level where they're not a problem.
And I just want to add that, you know, we see a lot of people that wash their hands. It's the quick underwater, dab, 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 and out the door. And really, in order to make a proper comparison, you need to wash your hands for, I've said before that when we talk to younger children, we use the example of singing happy birthday twice in a row. That's the duration of time we want you to really wash your hands. We want you to use soap when you wash your hands, and preferably with warm water. So, you know, do it in an efficient manner.